news and information in Southern California. Now, the latest breaking eyewitness news with Jerry Dunphy, Tawny Little, Johnny Mountain, Larry Carroll at the live-action camera desk, and the Eyewitness News team.
Good afternoon. Here's the latest at 4. Karen Carpenter died this morning at 9:51, the victim of cardiac arrest. The Grammy Award-winning singer with the mellow voice was only 32 years old. With her brother Richard, she soared to success and fame as the feminine half of the Carpenters with 60 million album sales.
If I listen long enough to you, I'd find a way to believe that it's all true. Knowing that you lied straight face while I cried, and still I look to find a reason to believe.
Someone like you makes it hard to live without somebody else.
Karen was brought to Downey Community Hospital after collapsing at her parents' nearby home. All efforts by paramedics and then the hospital staff failed to revive her. She had long been a victim of anorexia, a compulsion to thinness that can result in starvation. It's not known at this hour if that disorder played a part in her death. Her brother and her parents were with her when death came. Karen and Richard grew up in Downey and attended Downey Senior High. Karen's musical talent blossomed early. While still in school, she learned to play the drums and was part of the school's Vikings marching band. The Carpenters group started as a trio and won the Battle of the Bands in 1966. Later, it was just Karen and Richard and a skyrocketing career as a duo. There was a succession of awards, including numbers of gold records. In 1974, Barney Morris interviewed her.
Goes into making a hit act. I think it's, you know, luck, it's timing, it's...
A lot of hard work, guys.
Hard work too.
But you can have talent and you can be hardworking and you still...
Some people just never get the damn break they need, you know, it's
yeah.
Really a drag.
We've only just begun to live, white lace and promises, a kiss for luck and we're on our way.
We've only begun.
Karen Carpenter, much loved in the world of music. Dead at the age of 32. On Eyewitness News at 4:30, Bill Van Amberg will have a special report on this tragic loss to the music world.
For the second time in just 2 days, a truck driver has been shot at by a passing...
Carpenter died today of an apparent heart attack at the age of 32. Miss Carpenter was taken to Downey Community Hospital this morning after becoming ill at her parents' home in Downey. She was pronounced dead at 9:51 after a full cardiac arrest. Karen Carpenter and her brother Richard sold 60 million record albums worldwide, starting with their first big hit, We've Only Just Begun, in the early 70s. Bill Van Amberg reports now on the shocked reaction to Karen Carpenter's death in her hometown.
The Carpenter home, a well-known site for Downey residents, people who'd made it big but who kept their roots. And pulling some of his toughest duty today was Officer Robert Edmonds. Guarding the house, he'd gone to school with Karen.
Of course, it's still, I think, a shock to everyone. It probably hasn't settled in as to what happened within the community. There's probably been 100 or so cars driving by looking at the house.
The Carpenter influence extends across this city's fabric. Apartment buildings Karen and her brother own, named for their biggest songs. The family invested in hometown America, and it remembered. This is Karen's high school, and today the students dedicated this new outdoor stage, paid for with student money, in her honor. Graduating in 1967, people say this friendly singer and talented drummer was quiet, but knew where she was headed. Her band director remembers as well.
Said, I know that the family was a very close family, and a lot of times she'd just be with her brother all the time, going places, just because they were, you know, the ideal brother and sister situation. It was just one of those things where... You know, brothers and sisters aren't supposed to get along. But they always did very well, and they never really forgot where they come from. And that's important.
And even at the hospital today, people stopped to look in shock about their favorite family.
But they were good people, and they've always helped Downey out as far as I know. They've been around here all their lives, and they've done a lot for Downey, and they donated band equipment to Downey schools, and they've done a lot to help the community. And
people in this town talk very fondly about the Carpenters. They'll tell you about how they come by at Christmas because the house is decorated so nicely. And one person told me the family could have lived in Beverly Hills or anywhere else, but they didn't. They stayed in town, and people in Downey are awfully proud of that. Famous as Karen Carpenter might have been in the music world, she'll probably be best remembered for that here in Downey. I'm Bill Van Amberg, Channel 7 Eyewitness News.
Just as her friends are in shock in Downey, so are the many friends in the music world and the record community, too, in shock. On our 5 o'clock news, entertainment reporter Nancy Gould will have the full story of Karen Carpenter's show business career, a career that ended today with her untimely death at the age of 32.
For young Jason Leonard of Santa Ana, his first plane ride today could be a...
Mr. George Fishbeck with the weather, Larry Carroll at the live-action camera desk, and the Eyewitness News team.
Good evening, everybody. Here is the latest tonight at 5 o'clock. She left us all too soon. Karen Carpenter, whose soft and mellow voice was known to millions, died at a hospital in Downey this morning of cardiac arrest. Karen and her brother Richard, as the Carpenters, soared to success in the 1970s, putting romance back into popular music. All told, they sold some 60 million albums. Karen Carpenter rushed to Downey Community Hospital this morning by paramedics after collapsing at her parents' home nearby. All efforts to save her failed. She was pronounced dead this morning at 9:51. Carpenter was the victim of anorexia, a compulsion to diet which can lead to starvation. It's not known yet whether anorexia was partly responsible for her death at the very young age of 32. Some of Karen's fans, hearing the news, gathered outside the hospital.
But they were good people, and they've always helped Downey out as far as I know. They've been around here all their lives, and they've done a lot for Downey, and they donated band equipment to Downey schools, and they've done a lot to help the community. And
a longtime resident of Downey, Karen Carpenter had attended the local high school there. It was while there that her musical talent got its first recognition. She played the drums, was part of Downey High's marching band, and sang in the choir. The Carpenters first won real attention when they won the Battle of the Bands in 1966. Their first recording contract was with Herb Alpert of A&M Records, and from then on, only success, the Grammy Awards, and numbers of gold records. Karen's songs made a significant change in the musical tastes of the 1970s, from hard to soft and romantic rock. A loss to the entire world of music, and to all of us, Karen Carpenter dead at the very young age of 32. Anne?
You've been talking about it, Paul. She accomplished a great deal in the short time that she was alive. Karen Carpenter brought happiness to millions of people around the world who enjoyed her music and followed her career. Our Nancy Gold is with us right now for more on Karen's songs and her life. Nancy.
It's hard to believe, Anne. So sad. She'd only just begun to live. A tragedy befell Hollywood and the world today, having learned of the sudden death of singer Karen Carpenter, a woman who had dedicated her life to song.
Sing a song, make it simple to last your whole life long.
Karen and her brother Richard created the Carpenter sound. It was their distinctive close harmonies and sweet tones that helped to establish a trademark that was known indelibly as the Carpenter sound worldwide. During the 1970s, their romantic overdub style crept from top 40 AM radio to the FM dial's easy listening and some crossover country stations. Songs like We've Only Just Begun, Close to You, Top of the World, and For All We Know have long remained Carpenter classics. A high point in her career, the 70s, awarded the Carpenters huge success. They sold over 60 million albums worldwide and received several awards.
First of all, I'd like to thank all the members of NARIS and our producer, Jack Dougherty.
And Herb Alpert and Jerry Moss of A&M Records. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
There was plenty of white lace and promises for Karen Carpenter, but some of these promises led to personal disappointment.
When I it will be forever, or I'll never fall in love.
She was married on September 2nd to Thomas Barris of Newport Beach and was in the process of a divorce before she died. The last time Karen made a public appearance was a few weeks ago. When the Grammy Award nominations were announced, she was happy to be out with her friends.
A lot of times, things like this get everybody that hasn't seen each other for so long back together, and so it's a big party.
And the moment I can feel that, you feel that way too, is when I fall in love with you.
Earlier today, I spoke with Olivia Newton-John, who was one of Karen's closest friends. She was greatly shocked and saddened by her death, but made these comments, and I quote, "She was always concerned about other people. She was really a loving person. I'll miss her terribly. She was a loyal and wonderful friend. We will miss her too."
Yes, we will, Nancy. Coming up at 6 o'clock, Dr. William Rader will be here with more on Karen Carpenter, and particularly more on this dieting disorder, anorexia.
Until recently, she had built out of it. She had gained about 25 pounds. And like I said, she was really up and thrilled about going back into the studio recording and getting back on the road and getting on with her life. And it's just so sad to think she's gone.
Karen Carpenter, cardiac arrest. She was only 32.
Thank you, Gary. Also at the top of our news tonight, the unemployment picture.
And Bill Stout's perspective, the Channel 2 News at 6.
Good evening. It was a musical combination which started a new trend of soft rock in the 70s and bridged a generation gap. The Carpenters, a brother and sister singing team. Tonight, part of the team is gone. 32-year-old Karen Carpenter died this morning in Downey of cardiac arrest. Their clean-cut look and smooth harmonies help make them a singing success. Songs such as Close to You, Top of the World, We've Only Just Begun, shot up the pop charts and won them what the music industry calls a middle-of-the-road audience. It was a loyal following, proved in part by their 3 Grammys and 8 gold albums. Yes?
Karen Carpenter was found on the floor of a closet at the family home in Downey. She died apparently because her heart gave out. Her health had been plaguing her for some time. Dave Lopez is here with more on some of the circumstances leading to her death. David?
Just thank you. It was no secret among her Hollywood friends that Karen Carpenter suffered from anorexia nervosa, the term used when somebody simply stops eating and has no desire to eat at all. Within the hour, a coroner's autopsy has been completed, but no cause of death has been determined from that autopsy. In fact, lab tests and other studies will be needed, and that, says the coroner, could take weeks. Ms. Carpenter died just before 10 o'clock this morning from cardiac arrest. In layman terms, it means her heart stopped beating at 32 years of age.
We were directed by her father to an upstairs bedroom. At the one end of the bedroom was a very large walk-in closet. Inside of the closet area was Mrs. Carpenter and her mother at her side. Her mother was quite emotionally upset. She was removed from the area. We checked her, and we found a very faint, detectable pulse.
Captain Paul Cook, the first paramedic to reach Miss Carpenter.
It stopped or was not detectable at that time. We removed her from the closet.